What's up, guys? In this video, I'm going to show you how to insert markers in FL Studio. So you open up FL Studio, you have the playlist window right here, and then you navigate up to the playlist options up here, and then you navigate down to time markers, and then you can basically just add one. And then you can rename your marker. I'm just going to call this intro. And now we get like this playlist line up here with the markers. So now we have intro, and then you can basically just drag your playhead to where you want to add the second marker. So I'm going to add one here. So go to time markers, add one, and then press maybe I'll call this like build up. Okay, so let's say that you maybe like added a marker that was maybe not at the right position and you want to move it. You can actually just go up to the marker that you added, and then until you get this icon on your mouse, you can actually drag it. So you can drag it to maybe over here instead. And then the last one feature that you can do with the markers is that you can also rename them. So you right click on the marker that you want to rename and just press rename. Then we can call this drop one instead. And then finally, let's say that you want to delete your markers. You can simply just right click on the marker and press delete. So that's fairly simple to use the markers in FL Studio. So one reason why I love to use markers in FL Studio is that you can really quickly make a sketched out idea by using reference tracks. So right here, I just loaded up a reference track, and then I analyzed the track to where the intro is, the chorus, the verse, the chorus, the verse, chorus, and outro. So right now I actually have some guidelines to a song structure basically. So I can actually drag in some of my existing elements in my project to this skeleton basically. So this is really nifty if you maybe have produced an 8-bar loop, but you don't know like how to turn that into an actual song structure, like a full song. I recommend you to get a reference track that's within the genre or mood that you want to produce and make a song for, and just put it into FL Studio. Add some markers that could also be markers telling you that, okay, so right here you need to maybe chorus pull out hi-hats, maybe something like that. So you know like, okay, right here I maybe need to pull out my hi-hats and then maybe reintroduce them again. This is a really handy tool if you want to build full song structures in no time. Okay, so I'm also curious to hear about your favorite FL Studio tip. Please share it with me in the comments down below. If you need some other cool FL Studio tips and tricks, watch this video up here or up here. If you like this video, it means so much to me if you smash that like button or even subscribe to the channel. And don't forget to hit that notification bell so you never miss any future videos on the channel. I hope to see you in the next one. Take care. Peace.